We return tonight to the question of how and when we might reopen the country, or big parts of it, and return to something closer to normal. Former FDA Commissioner Dr. Mark McClellan has been working on a major roadmap to gradually reignite the economy. But that reopening would only happen after several important milestones are reached. Lawmakers and the White House are looking at the framework he proposed with former FDA Commissioner Scott Gottlieb. Dr. McClellan served in the George W. Bush administration. He's now the director of the Duke-Margolis Center for Health Policy at Duke University. Mark McClellan, welcome back to the NewsHour. It's so good to have you with us. I think, understandably, Americans right now want to believe that we are about to go back to normal within a matter of a few weeks. But it's not going to be quick and it's not going to be simple, is it?
It's not. We are doing a great job. Our healthcare systems dealing with the surge in cases, and Americans across the country taking important steps that have definitely slowed the spread of the virus. So we're getting past this initial surge, but this is really just the end of the beginning. The virus is going to be with us for a while. We can take steps to reopen our economy and get back toward normal, but it's going to be a new normal, and we need to put some real protections in place to harden our communities against the virus ever spreading like it has again.
And just as an example, social distancing is something people are going to be living with for a while.
And maybe even more, the steps that New York has recommended around wearing face coverings when you're in close quarters with other people, and steps in our businesses, in our schools to make it harder for the virus to be transmitted. We're going to see more of that in the months ahead.
Your report says that in order for this economy to be reignited, so to speak, that there has to be serious and comprehensive rapid testing, ample testing around the country. Give us a sense of what percentage of Americans would need to have this, and how fast the results would have to come before we can talk about anything close to normal.
Well, Judy, the goal here is to go from reacting to a spread of the virus that we really don't understand and haven't controlled well, except for these really extreme measures, to being able to identify any new outbreak very quickly and then take local, right around it, steps to contain it before it spreads further. And that means testing and tracing every case if possible. That's the goal. So that means diagnostic tests that are available quickly to everyone who might have symptoms that reflect COVID-19, and that's respiratory symptoms, fever, things like that, as well as people who are working in environments where there's a high chance of transmission, like a nursing home, for example. So we think that's on the order of 1 million tests or more per week across the United States. And it's not just having that many tests nationally, it's being able to get them quickly to every community in the country so that each community can keep the virus under control.
And how long is it going to take? I mean, is it even possible to say at this point?
Absolutely. And this is what we should be building for right now. It doesn't need to be that far off. The test capacity in the United States today, which includes public health labs, hospital labs that have expanded, commercial labs that have expanded, and other point of care testing with new testing mechanisms coming onto the market that can sometimes give test results very quickly right in the community, that can meet this capacity. But what we also need is the ability at the state and local level to make sure everyone has access, and then also make sure that we have the test materials we need to go along with the tests themselves, like swabs for tests that need to be done through the nose. We're working on new tests that can be done by spitting. That'll be easier to use.
But we know those things are not available right now, and it's going to take some time before they are everywhere they need to be. What about therapy in addition to testing? At what point and where are we in terms of coming up with a therapy that could be administered to people if they start to come down with coronavirus?
There are some very promising antiviral treatments that are in clinical testing now. For example, the drug remdesivir from Gilead. that could be available within a matter of a couple of months. There are other promising drugs that are already on the market or have been used for other purposes. There are efforts underway at FDA to speed the development of those drugs. And I think one additional step we could look at is going ahead with increasing their production so that they can be available in large quantities to help really support these steps to reopening sooner rather than later. A vaccine is still a little ways off, but there too, there are unprecedented efforts taking place not only in the United States, but in collaboration with other countries to do large-scale clinical testing fast, to get manufacturing done fast, and hopefully to make vaccines available in the next year or less as well.
And that's the timeline we hear, that at least a year or even a little beyond before there's a vaccine that can be widely available, not just in this country, but around the world. But there's also this what so-called contact tracing surveillance, being able to identify when people have been in touch with someone, who they've been in contact with, rather, who might have been infected. We're hearing from the tech companies like Google and Apple, they're trying to come up with an app. But we know that's complicated too, isn't it, Mark McClellan?
It is, but I think, once again, we can take some steps now to be ready for that surge in testing capacity that we're going to need in a matter of just a few weeks. So steps to make those test supplies more widely available, that's something that the government can be working on with the private sector now. And in terms of doing contact tracing, that is going to take more people, but this is a great area for further federal support to put those people in place, working with mayors, working with governors to ramp up the ability to track down people who may have been in contact, in close contact with people who test positive.
So Mark McClellan, when you look at all the things that are needed, we're talking about several months. We're not just talking about next month, May or June, are we?
Well, I think it depends on how fast areas can put together these capabilities and how hard hit they are now. Many areas of the country have been lucky. They haven't had very many cases. So for them, it will be relatively easy to put in place testing and tracking. It's not going to take as many people, not going to take as much resources. Still very important. People there are still vulnerable to the virus, but it could happen quickly. And throughout the country, I think this is going to happen in a stepwise fashion with maybe some limited reopening first. Schools should be a priority. Businesses that can make the steps to harden their ability to resist infection transmission. So I think you'll see progress within the next month, but it will happen at different paces across the country, and it really depends on getting these key capabilities in place to give people confidence they can go out and get back towards normal without risk of contracting the virus.
Mark McClellan, we certainly do hope to stay in touch with you as progress is made in this direction that everybody so badly wants. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.